These are live pictures of the visit to Papua New Guinea by the Holy Father, Pope Francis. It'll be a 4-day visit. Everybody at the airport is taking it all in. All eyes are focused on that Airbus, no doubt, and people outside as well. So are we here at the media center, and I'm sure everybody else who's watching. That's the site at Jackson's Airport in Port Moresby. What a memorable sight, the visit to Papua New Guinea by Pope Francis. He'll be here on Saturday and Sunday. A number of engagements are planned. He also visits Vanimore in the Sundown province. You know, some of the details, Archbishop, the population of Catholics in the world stand at 1.39 billion. And in Papua New Guinea, 96% of Papua New Guineans are Christians. And out of those, 30% of Papua New Guineans are Catholics. And that represents about 2.5 going on to 3 million people. And that's according to the 2011 census, and it's now almost 13 years and that census has never been updated, so that number could have increased. We could guess it and still get it right.
Yes, John, the population continues to grow.
Yes.
And one of the challenges in Papua New Guinea, we never get ourselves right with our census, but we do know that in the families there expanding and the challenges of school fees, feeding, and of course our schools and our health centers. These are the ones that measure how much are we catering for all our people.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely, Archbishop. A Garuda Airbus bringing the Holy Father into Port Moresby. The papal flag is flying as a normal protocol requirement. And coming from Indonesia, a country, an Islam country, Buddhism and Hinduism are strong. And the population there, 383 million people. Out of those, only 8.3 million are Catholics in Indonesia. And in Papua New Guinea, as we alluded earlier, 30% of the how many people we have right now, and as we said, the census is not updated. 30% are Catholics, but 96% of the people are Christians. Garuda Airbus, on board the Holy Father, Pope Francis.
It would be a different arrival if it was sunlight or sunset.
You'd have people hanging off branches and on rooftops. I'm not quite sure whether that's happening right now. It could be. It's dark, so we can't see. I'm sure people are seeking some vantage points to have a sneak preview of the arrival. There you are, the the Vatican flag and the PNG flag. How about that? It is looking at that picture, it is a picture of, if it's not excitement, then it is a one of anticipation of what might be, what might happen, what might be said, what might be the outcome when it's all over. At a time when Papua New Guinea is going through some difficult times of law and order, difficult times of hardships, difficult times politically.
You might also have to consider at this point with the advancement of information communications technology, that a lot of people are having personally following what is going on, which as before you would have a radio only or a TV for a big group of people. But now, given the personalized technology, everyone is to themselves watching what is going on.
We've come of time, haven't we? Yes, we have. Oh, yes, we have. So when the aircraft is parked and the engine stopped and when the Holy Father emerges and his entourage, people there to greet him and follow through the protocols, will, as we said, the Deputy Prime Minister, the Honorable John Rosso is already there representing the government and the people of Papua New Guinea to welcome the Holy Father. And with him are a number of ministers, including the Honorable Justin Chechenko, the Minister for Foreign Affairs. And he's there in his capacity as welcoming a dignitary from another country who's the head of state as well. There also, no doubt, with the other government officials, members of the Honorable Powers Pakong is also there. He will be, he's kind of hosting the Papua District of the National Capital District, National Capital District, so he's the governor here, he's there to welcome him. And the people, the traditional landowners and the people here, the Motupoitabo, are represented. They're at the coming at the airport by Daddy Topa Jr., the chairman of the Motu Kwaitabu. And then of course for representing the public servants out there is Ivan Pomala, the Chief Secretary to Government, and also the Secretary of Foreign Affairs, Mr. Elias Wahenge. On the Vatican side, there is, of course, His Eminence, Cardinal Sir John Ribbon, representing the Archdiocese of Port Moresby, playing host to the visit by the people. And then, of course, you will have the representatives of the Apostolic Nunciature, that's like the embassy of the Vatican Embassy here in Port Moresby, in Papua New Guinea. You also have His Excellency Otto Sepre. He's the Bishop of Barena and the President of the Catholic Bishops Conference. A little bit dark out there, and of course out at the tarmac you don't have lights. Like you, if it was daytime, then it would be very clear, but yes, it's somebody switch on some lights there. Wow. I said the magic word, did I? There's the crew that was responsible for flying the Holy Father from Jakarta in Indonesia to Port Moresby in Papua New Guinea. A trip that took almost 5 to 6 hours. We're waiting for the moment when all will be cleared for disembarkation of the people on board. And just in front of the aeroplane, the Airbus is a little, almost like a smaller miniature Toyota, but it is specially fitted for the Holy Father to be driven from there to a New Guinea hill. Now these are the Mekio dancers, Mekio performers who are there to welcome. And I think it was done in the previous visits by Pope John Paul II, and on his two visits here, the Mekios had gone out there and had performed and had welcomed. These pictures are coming to you live, wherever you are. Live from Jackson's Airport in Port Moresby. The Garuda Airbus that has just flown in, the Holy Father and his entourage, and landed at Jackson's Airport a few minutes ago. It's been a long flight, and I'm sure he's had a pretty long day in Indonesia. So from here, there are no other programs planned. As he steps down from the plane, he will take the guard of honor, say hello to the dignitaries there, take the guard of honor, and then will be taken to a New Guinea hill where the apostolic nuncio sitcha is. That's the embassy of the Vatican. And these are some of the clergy out there. Archbishop, you know them. Who are they?
What we just see a while ago is the president, Bishop Otto Separi, the Bishop of Brena. He's the president of the Catholic Bishops Conference. And was standing to his back was Bishop Joseph Rosinski.
Okay.
The Bishop of Quebec. And all the others, the rest, everybody, I think at this point is nothing much they can say. They're just looking.
Just sort of watch.
And just taking it in.
Yes. Yes. So they've obviously opened two doors. One at the back, I take it, will be the entourage, the accredited media. Will come out of there. Some security personnel. The steps in the front will be where the Holy Father will no doubt will be guided down. And there's some of the members, part of the entourage, coming down at the back end. And if they are media people, they will no doubt circle the front to take pictures. That's what they came for, and they're not going to miss this opportunity. And in Papua New Guinea, we offer a different kind of reception with the young Mekio dancers who are dressed up in front. Here are some members of the security personnel making sure that the Holy Father is safe. Trained personnel, so they swift into action. Now, the members of some of our dignitaries, as well as the two Mekio girls dressed in Mekio dress, will welcome the Holy Father. Is there any specific order under which the bishops go to meet the Holy Father there? Were they picked? Were they chosen? Or how is that arrived at?
John, what is happening is all the bishops are invited to be present for the arrival to greet the Holy Father, because. In most cases, he is the what we refer to as the supreme pontiff, who is the overall boss. And everybody, we normally every 5 years we have to go and give an account on how you're running your dioceses or archdioceses. And so he is also keen to meet each one. And recently we just met him in Rome last year. And now when he comes and see the bishops or meet the bishops on their own turf, it's a bit of a different experience for the Holy Father as much as for the bishops themselves. So in that regard, there is no, of course, we have the cardinal and the chairman of the bishops' conference, the president, and then the rest. That's about it. We'll be having also a few others who arrived. The other cardinal from Tonga and another archbishop from Fiji and from New Zealand, who just felt that this, because we are making Papua New Guinea as representing the Oceania, and so these other bishops felt that they have to be here to representing their four conferences, Australia, New Zealand, and CPAC is all the nations in the Pacific Ocean, and Papua New Solomon Islands. So this is why we are hearing the referral or the references that this visit is a pastoral and apostolic visit of His Holiness Pope Francis to this to Asia and Oceania. And we, Papua New Guinea, seems to be at the borderline between Asia and Oceania. Yeah.
Well, we're the bridge.
Yeah, yeah.
We're the bridge. We'll break into a little bit of pigeon here, Archbishop. Online blog Papua New Guinea. You may talk minutes. This la balush, a karim. Pope was at the kam luki mipla kam lo country blog mipla. Balush e kam pon down minutes. Na online or big line blog government na lotu tu. Holy God of bless balush long. Go kiss him, talk welcome long em, na kiss him. Na em by he got plenty of program, long em, long working, long Port Moresby, long Saturday, na Sunday. Na two em by go long Vanimore, long West Civic Province. You go look him all some long missionary, Satoli come long place where em come long em. Em come long one blah South American country, all you call him Argentina. Na little old missionary. All some old sister or walk line, all come long up. Now you look all same old line here, he come down the front end, and all some old line who said he come on them, eh? I think only come pass long. Ready long end by come down. Me blow wait yet. All got to look strong, Archbishop.
John, display balus. You know one kind of symbol balus you missa lukim long kind of semi triple all exit ya lo back side long front nothing long side you go too long left hand you can look him so in look semo kataman in look ta sol na wait which one by Papa Santu come out long him Holy Father by come long this la
Eminenza. Prego, seguite Melania, prego, la ragazza è lì, prego, lei resti.